Hello to everyone. Hello, Mr. Ambassador of the Federal Republic of Germany to the Hellenic Republic, Andreas Kiedel. He asked me to call him Andreas, so I'm going to address him with a small name, Greek name. Welcome to the Delphi Forum.
Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ.
Καλώς ορίσατε.
Θα ήθελα να συνεχίσουμε να συζητήσουμε στα ελληνικά, αλλά νομίζω ότι τα αγγλικά σας είναι πιο καλύτερα από τα ελληνικά μου. So let's talk in English.
Παρ' όλα αυτά τα λέτε πολύ καλά τα ελληνικά. Αν ακούσετε τα γερμανικά μου θα κλάψετε. Οπότε θα συνεχίσουμε στα αγγλικά. It is with great honor to welcome you here. I was planning on starting this conversation quite differently, but Mr. Schäuble's book came into my hands on Sunday with the title Memories, My Life in Politics, where he describes all the meetings with the Minister of Finance, Greek Minister of Finance, the Eurogroup meetings about Greece, the meeting with Prime Minister Mr. Alexis Tsipras, with details. And I would like to ask you, 13 years later of this situation, what does Greece mean to Germany?
I also looked at the book when it came out on, I looked at it on Monday actually, because I had difficulties in downloading it on my app. And I can only recommend to everyone to read the book and not just the parts that have been published in Kathimerini and other newspapers concerning Greece, because it gives you a fuller picture of a episode of Greek-German relations that seem to have been particularly toxic and particularly vitriolic. But I have to say that Greek-German relations have been long, have been very strong and remain to be strong. I don't know whether you know that the orange trees you can see in Athens on the streets have been planted or initialed by the wife of the first Bavarian king here in Greece. And it continues like this strong relationship. And this year particularly, 2024, is a year of jubilees, of anniversaries. We have 150 years of the German Archaeological Institute. We have 100 years of the German-Greek Chamber of Commerce, 60 years of Deutsche Welle Greek program, and so on. And on top of that, Germany's honorary country at the Thessaloniki International Fair in September. So this is a very important year for us. And at the moment, I think my fear is more than coming from this difficult period of a special focus on Wolfgang Schäuble during the crisis. I think now, by now, more and more people understand how the narrative should have been and how circumstances were actually in 2010, 2015, and so on. And what we are seeing now, my fear is that we are coming from a very difficult short period into a period of indifference, more than excitement, rather. So there is, I think for me as an ambassador who has arrived here 6 months ago, plenty of work to do to try to make these relations between our two countries more lively than they have been in the last couple of years.
What do you set as a priority for you as an ambassador?
Yeah, I think for me it is important to have these institutions we have mm-hmm. that manifest, in my point of view, a very strong relationship over the last 200 years, if you want, or almost, and stabilize those institutions, because I think what we have in terms of personal relationship between Greeks and Germans is very strong. I mean, we have plenty of tourists here. We have a lot of Greeks in Germany, yes. a history of that. So I think my idea is to put more life into those institutions we have.
Okay, this is a priority, I guess. And as you mentioned about the touristic flow, Germans love Greece during summertime, I guess. And I would like to ask you, what does this mean to you?
We have, I just saw
and
my...
And for both countries, excuse me.
I just saw my British colleague here. We are debating internally who, whether there are more Brits or more Germans tourists in Greece. We make up roughly 5 million, and since he's not here, I can claim we are.
You can say whatever you want.
So, and not just they come in summer, but they also invest. In terms of buying homes, I went to Heraklion recently, and only in the city of Heraklion you have 3,000 Germans buying an apartment or a house.
You love Crete.
Yes, we love Crete. And I think what it means for, you don't need to do any advertising for Greece and Germany, because it's so obvious that we also go to Cyprus, of course, but it's so obvious that we want to go to Greece and spend as much time as we can here. And you have an increasing number of pensioners staying in Greece.
So do Greek people travel to German as much as German travel to Greece?
Yeah, not as much, but traditionally there's a strong flow of Greeks. There's, especially from the north of Greece, there's a widespread knowledge of German, the language, for historical reasons mainly. And you have a lot of Greeks in Germany at a time when it was difficult to find a job in Greece. A lot of Greeks went to Germany and stay there now. So yes, there's a large. We have many Greek schools in Germany. So there's a large Greek population. Not as many
Germans
coming to Greece as tourists, but yeah.
So let's talk about migration flows. One of the most critical problems Greece is facing, not only Greece, but Greece is facing as well. Since January, more than 1,180 migrants have arrived to Crete and Gavdos. Neither of these islands have migrant reception facilities. Today, the migration crisis is one of the biggest problems of Europe. What do you think we should do about that? Not as Greek, but as European people.
Yeah. I mean, we have found an agreement on the asylum system in Europe very recently. Of course, this needs to be implemented. We need to have further regulations on it. But on migration, let me say one thing. Greek migration minister is very active. He is bringing a new proposal to cabinet and to parliament, where he adds additional elements that show that the idea of migration is not anymore seen just negatively, because all countries in Europe need foreign workforce, because we have in our own country mostly a lack of a workforce and a lack of, it's a demographical issue. Mm-hmm. So
A solution?
It's been recognized, I think, in many European countries that there is this illegal migration we don't want.
Yes.
And there needs to be legal migration, because we
And the refugees.
Refugees, yes. So I think it's recognized in Europe that Greece as a frontier state, if you want, as external
reception
borders of the European Union is particularly under pressure by increasing numbers of migrants coming. But The interesting fact maybe is that Greece by migrants is seen as a transit country. Mm-hmm. Most of the migrants that are coming to Greece want to leave as soon as possible and go to Germany.
Yes.
So and to other countries in Europe. So what I can see with admiration is that the Greek government has managed to proceed to fasten procedures, to have additional elements to govern these migration flows, and I think it's doing well, because you can see now the migration centers you have on the islands are not full, they're not overfilled, so there's space, and I think most of those migrants that are coming to Greece really want to leave after a certain period of time.
Andreas, what is the role of Turkey in the migration crisis?
For me, it's difficult to say. I know that you know that there it seems that I mean I know that Turkey can regulate obviously. Because most of the migrants that are coming now to Greece are coming by sea. Most of them are coming from the Turkish coast. So obviously, there is a managerial problem, if you want, or a managerial purpose. You can actually manage these flows if you want. So it seems that at some times Turkey wants to manage these flows. For instance, now in March, we have a relatively low number of migrants coming overseas from Turkey compared with February, maybe half of the number. But you mentioned also Gavdos, and this is a new route, which is worrying, because mm-hmm. already now in the first 3 months of this year, there were more illegal migrants coming to Gavdos than in the whole year, last year. And this is a difficult problem with an island which has
the reception
70
facilities.
Inhabitants, yes. And now suddenly hundreds of illegal migrants.
So, okay, let's.
But
move
I,
on.
If I can add to Turkey, and
yes,
the minister,
yes.
The minister mentioned this also earlier. Our impression in Germany is that since last year, since high-level meetings, mm-hmm. since a implementation of the positive agenda, since a exact timeline, never mind that some of the meetings did not take place in time but were postponed. But with a timeline, I think the overall atmosphere in terms of discussing issues with the between the Greek and the Turkish side is positive. Of course, as he mentioned, the real big topics are not being touched, but nobody expects this at this moment. But in the small topics, we are doing progress. Until a week ago, now since a week ago, there's a new regime of Turkish tourists coming
for
to five of the islands,
yes.
Which is, I think, for the Turkish side, a very positive development. It's an interesting development. So there's a little movement, I think.
Okay. So what do you think about the climate change? We're living difficult times on climate crisis.
Yeah.
What do you think we could do as a German ambassador as well from your side and here in Greece in order to prevent or, let's say, face this climate crisis?
Unfortunately, or luckily, I would rather say, as a German ambassador, I can't do
yes,
a lot about climate
because
change.
I was looking at the temperatures in Germany, and I saw something 30 degrees.
Maybe, yes, yes. I like it here, so. No, the what we saw last year, of course, all those floods, fires, we can see, and which will repeat themselves this year, most probably next year, and so on. And we have this statistic saying this was the warmest month since, and we can repeat this now every month and every year. What I can say is that Greece is, the Greek government is very much aware about this and doing quite a lot. We had discussions with the Ministry of Energy and on the results of the COP27. Mm-hmm. We had a, and we can see that Greece and Greek government is doing a lot in terms of mitigating the consequences of climate change. We try to help where we can, and this is a problem for all of Europe and the whole world. So I think the issue is best kept within the international fora where we can deal with these issues. And we have global goals we have set up, and my understanding is that Greece is among those who is a champion of reaching these goals in time, mm-hmm. other than other countries in the European Union. And I'm not taking exception for Germany, because we have we are also struggling with this this idea. And obviously, Greece is for us an important hub, an important source for renewable energy. And this is one issue where German companies are rather interested in getting in touch with the Greek counterparts and with the Greek government in order to increase our sources of renewable energy.
Okay. Και πριν σας αποχαιρετήσω, θα ήθελα να μου πείτε το αγαπημένο σας φαγητό. Είστε 6 μήνες στην Ελλάδα. Ξέρω όμως ότι είχατε σπουδάσει και αρχαία ελληνικά και λατινικά. Είστε λάτρης ουσιαστικά της Ελλάδας. Οπότε θα ήθελα να ξέρω το αγαπημένο σας φαγητό. Το ελληνικό φαγητό, προφανώς.
It's true that I studied ancient Greek and I did some modern Greek all the time. This is the first time I can practice my Greek, and I have more time to get in touch with the Greek cuisine. So I'm getting all kinds of ideas what to eat when I'm traveling the country. So particularly, I'm interested in the different types of cheese they have in the islands, and I also like the local variations of Lukanika. So.
Okay. Σας ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Thank you so much.
Και εγώ. Μια χαρά.
Thank you. Thank you so much.